KK English Channel.
Hello kids, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to lesson 46. Hello 同学们好，今天我们会进入第46堂课了。Let's learn materials. Materials 指的是材料。Let's see what material we learn today. 那么今天一起来看看要学什么材料吧。We are learning to, 我们要学的是 1. Match at least 4 or more materials for the clothes based on the audio. 所以今天要学的是衣服的材料。聆听录音后搭配至少四个衣服的材料。 2. Say out at least 4 or more materials for the clothes. 说出至少四个衣服的材料。所以我们来看看究竟什么东西能够支撑我们的衣服。 What is this? It's cotton. 棉花。 Did you know where does cotton comes from? 这个棉花来自哪里呢？ Cotton comes from plants. Plants 是什么？ Plants 就是植物。 After we collect the cotton, we send the cotton to a factory to process. 我们收集这些棉花后送去工厂加工。 Finally,It will become shorts and t-shirt we wear. 最后就是我们穿的衣服了。Let's watch a short video about process cotton become clothes. 我们来看一段棉花制成衣服的视频。棉花是一种需要热带气候、温暖的阳光，还有足够的雨水才能成长的植物。棉花的孢子越来越成熟的时候就会打开来，白白的棉花球就会蹦的跑出来咯。工人会收集这些棉花球，也就是 cotton balls， 把它们加工变成棉线团。你知道吗？棉花是有种子的哦。员工们可以用手或者是机械来取走这些种子。当我们用手把棉花球搓啊搓，就会变成一条纤维棉线了。所以这些棉线球再拿来加工，就是我们穿的 cotton shirt 了。 So, let's go to the second material. What's this? This is wool, 羊毛。 The wool comes from sheep. 羊毛就是指羊的毛哦。 Do you know how we get the wool? 我们怎么获取羊毛的呢？用拔的还是剪下来？都不是哦。The workers shave the wool. 就像你去理发店一样，那员工会用剃刀把羊毛剃下来 and send it to the factory. Finally, we can get our sweater and socks. Let's go to the next slide. The second video is about wool. So let's see where we can get wool. 在澳大利亚的国家，人们在宽阔的大草地上圈养羊群。他们每天带领成群的羊儿到大草原上吃草。在每年的春天，牧羊人会为羊儿剃毛，员工们会将羊毛储存起来，准备售卖。当他们需要使用羊毛时，会先将羊毛放入机械中清洗干净。他们会重复的将羊毛清洗八次。过后放入另一台机械，将羊毛卷成一条长线。之后他们将羊毛染色。在这影片中有不同颜色的羊毛。之后应用人工或者是机械编辑成线。而这些机械呢，会把线编织成棉被、毛衣、袜子等等。那在这影片的最后，你可以看到，这阿姨也可以用手动来织成毛衣哦。 Let's go to the third material. Do you know what's this? This is leather. 皮革. It comes from cow. 我们所说的 leather 就是牛的皮。The worker take the skin from a cow and make it into jacket, shoes, belt. 当然还有其他的动物也可以制成 leather, 比如羊皮、蛇皮。可是有些动物的皮是不能拿来做衣服的，比如老虎皮、豹皮，杀这些动物都是犯法的哦。Let's watch a short video about how leather made of. 我们来看一段制造皮革的视频吧。动物们被送进工厂之后呢，员工们会先将动物的皮剥下，撒盐，然后放入冰箱冻结。冻结了一段时间过后，他们就会将这些皮取出来，然后送去另一间工厂清洗，过后进行加工。这清洗的过程主要是清除动物皮表面上的毛发、血迹、污渍和盐，过后就会被送去加工。制成皮革之后，就可以为皮革涂上颜色，然后提升它的防水功能。接着会为皮革印上花纹，最后会被送去工厂开始制作我们日常所需的用品，如座位、沙发、皮制品和鞋子。 Let's go to the next slide. Let's match the material for the clothes after listening the audio. 那我们接下来会听一段录音，然后搭配衣服的材料吧。拿出一张纸，把你的答案记录起来。
Cotton comes from plants. You can wear cotton shorts and t-shirts. Leather comes from cows. You can wear leather shoes and jackets. Wool comes from sheep.You can wear woolen sweaters and socks.
Now, let's find out which clothes is made from cotton. 棉花。 And they are shorts and t-shirt. Are you correct too? Well done. Which clothes are made from leather? 皮革的 shoes and jacket.Do we have the same answers? Very good. Wool. We can make socks and sweater. Did you all correct? Let's continue. Say the materials for the clothes. You can pause the video and match the clothes with materials. Let's check the answer. With cotton, we can make a cap and an apron.We can use wool to make hat and gloves. Belt and shoes is made from leather. Let's say the materials for the clothes with Mr. Tiong. Like this. Picture 1 is cotton. Picture 2 is leather. Picture 3 is wool.Picture 4 is wool. Picture 5 is cotton. Picture 6 is leather. Thanks for watching. Bye.